Hey guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back. Today I've got another video focusing on underrated and overrated products. So I had a video go up about a week or two ago talking about eyeshadow palettes, and I shared the ones that I felt were overrated, underrated, and then I also threw in some that I thought were rated appropriately. So if you missed that video, it will be linked down below, but I know a lot of you guys really enjoyed that, so I thought it would be fun to do a part two talking about a lot of other categories. So I went through many of our favorite makeup categories, and for each one I picked out a product that I felt was overrated and one that was underrated. So if you're new to my channel, I do upload 4 to 5 videos a week. I would love for you to subscribe, but let's go ahead now and hop into it. Let's start off with foundation. Okay, my overrated one, I think many of these obviously are unpopular opinions, because these products do get a lot of hype, but this first one in particular, so many people love, but it was not for me. And it's the Pure Love Yourselfie Foundation. So for most of the overrated ones, I have decluttered them, so you probably won't see them in person. I'll pop photos up for you to look at. Okay, first of all, it broke me out. Don't love that. But my main issue with it was just the way that it looked and felt on my skin. And the way that I describe it, I feel like my description of it and my vision of it is the exact opposite of what I hear from so many other people. I hear so many people say that it looks natural, it looks like skin, but for me, my experience was the complete opposite. I felt like I was wearing a mask. It felt so thick and cakey, and I just think up close, it looked really heavy, and the coverage was just way too full for my preference. Now, that definitely does come down to preference, so if you want extreme coverage, you might love that about the foundation, but for me, I just felt like it looked too heavy. Instead, my favorite full coverage is this one. This is my underrated option. This is from Koki. It's their full cover foundation. So one thing I wanted to mention, I've had some comments about a lot of the shades being out of stock for a while. So I did reach out to my contact at Koki, and what she told me was that with everything happening with COVID, the manufacturer is in Italy and they had to shut down and weren't able to fulfill their orders. So they're now looking for somewhere else. So I was told that they're hoping to have it back soon, but what is soon? I don't really know. But for me, this is just a better alternative to the Pure Foundation. The price tag is about a third of the Pure Foundation. And for me, I still get a high level of coverage, maybe not as extreme as the Pure Love Yourselfie, but it's definitely the most full coverage in my collection. But it sits a little bit better on the skin. It wears better throughout the day. You know, it is full coverage, but it doesn't look like a mask on me, and that's why I love it. Overrated, underrated concealers. My overrated has got to be the Tarte Shape Tape. This, I think, is very overrated. Here's the thing. I think a few years ago when this first released, it made a big splash in the industry because we weren't used to seeing such extreme coverage concealers. And at the time, I felt that it was worth the hype, but these days, I feel like there are better options that don't look as heavy and aren't quite as dry. So for me, my underrated option, I gotta be honest, this was kind of hard because I feel like many of the concealers that I love get a decent amount of hype. And I don't think this is like that underhyped, but this is the one I decided to go with. This is the CoverGirl True Blend Undercover Concealer. This really is a fantastic alternative to the Shape Tape. It's a lot more comfortable on the under eyes. I think truly it's a great dupe for the Born This Way from Too Faced. You guys know my number one favorite concealer formula is the Milani Conceal Imperfect, but that one I feel like gets a lot of attention. This one does get talked about, but not as much. And you get a lot of bang for your buck here. I've noticed that the cost varies a lot at different retailers. At some locations, I can find it under $10. At some, it's like $11 or $12. But you get the same amount of product as the Tarte Shape Tape. It comes with 10 milliliters or 0.33 fluid ounces. Very comfortable, very high coverage as well. Highly recommend that one. Okay, bronzers. This one was a bit tricky as well. I'm like, what am I gonna go with for my overrated bronzer? Because looking through my collection, I don't really have any bronzers that I think are so bad that also get so much hype that they don't deserve. You know what I mean? But I started to think about one that used to be super, super hyped up on YouTube. Not so much in 2020, but if we think back to like YouTube 2014, the Milani baked bronzers were super popular. And just overall, the Milani baked formulas, the blushes and the bronzers, This I got sometime last year, and I was so excited to try it because it had been so hyped up. The shade that I have is 9, and don't get me wrong, I don't think it's a bad formula, and I don't dislike baked products, but the thing about baked products is they're just inherently dry, and that's the thing. So some formulas can be baked and not feel as dry, but this one definitely is more of that dry formula. So on the cheeks, I don't think it has as much of like a natural sheen or finish as something like the Silky Matte Bronzer from Milani. I don't think that this is a bad bronzer, but I don't think it looks as natural and as perfected on the skin as most of my other bronzers. It's definitely lower on my bronzer ranking if you saw that video earlier this year. Also, it has some glitter particles on the skin. They're not really that noticeable unless you get like way up close. But in general, I don't hate it. I don't think it's terrible. I really don't even think it's that bad, but my expectations were way up here because of how hyped up it was back in like OG YouTube days. And then when I tried it, I was like, oh, it's okay. Underrated though, I'm going with a bronzer palette. This is from Essence. This is a newer product. It came out earlier this year. This is their Sun Club Matte Bronzing Palette. Really fantastic formula. I had a top 5 video from Essence go up earlier this month. I'll leave it linked below if you missed it, but I mentioned this as one of the top 5 products. This is $10, so it's a pretty similar price tag to this individual bronzer from Milani, but the formula is much creamier. Fantastic. Okay, blush. This is one I think a lot of people are gonna get mad at me about, but don't get mad at me, it's just my personal opinion. And again, I don't think this is a terrible blush, but based on how hyped up it was, my expectations were right here, and I tried it, and I was like, oh, okay. It's just a blush. So this is from Hourglass. I know so many people swear by this formula. It's like their top blush formula. But the shade that I picked out is Mood Exposure. My number one recommendation, if you want to try these out, the blushes at least, pick up a mini. Blush is a product that's so hard to go through. You probably will not go through a full size, so I think it makes a lot of sense to pick up the mini. These are, well, some of the minis from Hourglass range. They're typically between $20 and $24 for the mini size products. Now, I do like having this in my collection. It's kind of a nice, like, cooler toned blush for me. I do think that it stands out in my collection, at least based on the tone of it. And it's definitely creamy. And kind of going back to that baked idea, this is a softer baked formula. It doesn't feel as dry as the Milani bronzer. But I just think I was expecting this blush to change my life, and I put it on and I was like, okay, it's a blush. I don't know if I would have paid $40-something for the full size blush, you know? I don't think it's terrible, but I do think it's a little overrated. Underrated was tricky because for me, many of my favorite blush formulas, I feel already get a decent amount of attention. And this is the same thing. I think this already gets a decent amount of attention, but it really is fantastic, and I think it could have even more hype. So this is the new blush formula from Persona. I say new. It's been around for a little while now. It's not brand new, but they have 2 shades. This is the shade Carmel, and they also have Georgia. Carmel is stunning. And the thing about this, I've seen it on so many different skin tones, and it really looks beautiful on such a range of people. And what I like about this formula, it's pretty pigmented. It's funny too. This is the Persona swatch. This is the Hourglass swatch. This one I built up, this one I did not. And the way that they designed these was to be kind of a hybrid between a shimmery blush and a matte blush. Kind of somewhere in the middle, a little more like a satin formula, where they're not flat matte powdery blushes that look dry and artificial on the cheeks, but they're not shimmery blushes. I don't like my blush to be that shimmery. I feel like from far away it looks nice, but then you get up close and it's like, okay, you have glitter particles all over your cheek. I really appreciate that this is somewhere in the middle where the cheeks look like they have a nice sheen to them. They really mimic the texture of skin, but they're not powdery. Overrated highlighter. These are the Diamond Glow highlights from Too Faced. Now, I didn't hate this formula. Again, we're really discussing a lot of baked formulas in this video, and they're all ending up in the underrated or the overrated category, actually. With this formula, I did enjoy it on the days that I wanted a softer highlight. But here's the thing, you will never get, like today I'm a little more intense, I'm wearing my Ofra highlighters today, you know those are glowy, glowy, glowy. You're never gonna get that look out of this highlighter. Not necessarily a bad thing, but again, I feel like baked formulas are a little bit harder to do and to make look creamy and natural on the skin. And this just ended up being a little bit dry. I think a lot of the hype came from the packaging. It's beautiful. It's a little bulky, but it's really, really pretty. Also, these kind of have a fun, like subtle duochrome shift to them. In theory, they're really cool products, but I ended up decluttering all the shades I had. Underrated. Mine is in a little plastic sleeve. This is from Ciate London. This is their Moondust highlighter. That's the name of the shade. Their highlighter formula deserves so much more hype. So their highlighters, they're very easily manipulated. So there's the shade. And when I say easily manipulated, I mean that with a certain brush, you can get something a little softer. With a brush that has a little bit more density to it and a heavier hand, you can get something very intense. But the formula on the skin is so baked and not baked. I'm talking about way too many baked products here. I was trying to say creamy and smooth. Where did baked come from? It's just so creamy on the skin, and especially that shade Moondust is so beautiful. I don't know why people aren't talking about the Ciate highlighters. Out of everything in this video, I feel like those are the most underrated. Like some of these, I'm like, you know, Taylor Wynn likes this foundation. I know that she's given it a lot of attention. People definitely talk about the CoverGirl concealers, but the Ciate London highlighters, I don't hear anyone talking about, and they're amazing. All right, the final category is mascara. This one, the overrated one. I feel like people are gonna get mad at me because I know so many people live for this mascara. This is from CoverGirl. This is their Exhibitionist mascara. Now, do I think it's a bad mascara? No. But again, it has so much hype that when I first tried it, I was like, this is gonna change my life. It's gonna be my new favorite mascara, my number one formula. And it's just good for me. It's not great. I think it makes a fantastic alternative to the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. I think it's a great dupe for that one. But I just find that it gives me a decent amount of length, a decent amount of volume, but not a ton of either one. I get a little bit of separation, not a ton. And it doesn't last all day. I do notice some of it kind of fading throughout the day. So for that, I think it's a good mascara. But I don't think it's amazing. But what I do think is amazing, and no one talks about, is the Mad Lash from The Balm. This mascara is fantastic if you love length. It's also very separating, and you guys, this mascara, out of anyone I've ever tried, is the one that I get the most compliments on, the most questions on. Like, I will be in public and complete strangers will stop me to say, wait, what mascara are you wearing? Your eyelashes look amazing. You guys know, though, I did pick up the e.l.f. Keep Your Curl, which is supposed to be a dupe for it. I'm planning to test that out, but I have two mascaras open at the moment and I don't like to open more than one or two at a time. So I'm trying to hold off and wait, but don't worry, I will test that soon. I've had a lot of comments and questions about that. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video about overrated and underrated products. Like I said, I will have the palette version of this video linked down below if you want to check it out. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.